I am futurist, Amelia. As a futurist, it's my job to know about the latest new and coming technologies and their potential impact on the future of business and our lives. As a naturally curious person, asking annoying questions is my forte. And one I have recently been trying to get to the bottom of is this. Is the metaverse bad for the environment? And if it is, why isn't anyone talking about it? I've been talking about the metaverse since around 2017. And while I'm a big fan of the metaverse, and was Eve Finley recently named one of the top 25 women in the metaverse, today I'm not gonna stand up here and tell you how amazing it is or how it's gonna change our lives. Instead, I want to focus on this question around the environmental impact. It's a question that is receiving so little attention, study, and discussion that it's actually made me wonder if I am the only one who has these concerns, or if we're all just running late to this party, and it is actually something that we should be discussing today. I don't come from a technology background. I grew up as a child actress. I owned an illegal speakeasy in New York, and I opened up the first burlesque and cabaret nightclub in China. Then I got thrown out of China, and I ended up here in this lovely country. And it took me 2 years to get a visa to work, during which time I wrote my first book. But as soon as I got a visa, I needed a job, any job, I didn't care. And I had a friend who was going to an innovation conference. And I said, let me go along with you. I'll host your booth, I'll network, maybe someone will hire me. And I go along, and there's this booth next to ours. And it has all this really cool technology. It has touchscreen tables and virtual books and holograms. And I had never seen anything like it. And I kept going over and asking lots of questions and then bringing my people over and explaining to them what had been explained to me. And finally someone says, do you work for us? And I said, no, but I should. And a week later, I was hired as a marketing assistant at a creative technology agency. And there, I worked my way up to become their global head of innovation. I opened up innovation labs in London and Dubai and Scotland for some of the biggest consultancies in the world. But after several years, something didn't feel quite right. I always felt a bit compromised being in a situation where I had to market and sell these technologies when really I understood that while they pose great opportunities, equally, they pose new risks. And no one was talking about that. So in 2017, I went independent as a futurist, and I started working with insurance companies and banks and retailers, and even our government, researching, writing reports, advising, and speaking about how we can implement responsible technology strategies today that are going to have the most positive impact in the future. So when I started to look into this question, I was shocked by how little there is out there about it. This is one of the challenges in my line of work. Often I'm trying to research something that's so new and futuristic that there are no studies to turn to. So I like to start with something that we already know about and see where that leads. And in this case, that's gaming. So raise your hand if you are a gamer. Okay, a couple people. Okay, now raise your hand if you know someone who is a gamer. Right, okay, that's practically everyone in the room. So it shouldn't surprise you to learn that 77% of millennials and 81% of Gen Z consider themselves gamers. Gaming has overtaken pop music and Hollywood to become the largest media sector in the world. And in these recent years, we have seen these gaming environments shift to become 3D, immersive, persistent, and social. And this is the model for the metaverse. This is what the future of the internet is going to look like. We are going to move from something that's 2D into something that's 3D, immersive, persistent, and social. So you might already be familiar with some metaverses like Roblox or InView or The Sandbox or Decentraland. And while today we mostly interact with metaverses from our PCs, we know that every major technology company is currently working on headsets and smart glasses that will offer us a new way to interface with these 3D environments, one that engages the brain in an even more stimulating way. And their major goal, their business model, is to shift the perception from these technologies being seen as a shared technology into becoming a personal technology, like a smartphone. So I don't know how many of you have tried virtual reality glasses or mixed reality or augmented reality before, but while they're improving, they tend to be a bit big and heavy and uncomfortable. But this is going to change. And it's going to change largely to advances in networking. So as soon as we can start pushing the processing and the computing from the headsets into the cloud, the headsets are going to become smaller, they're going to become lighter, more fashionable, and importantly, the cost is going to come down, making the goal of everyone eventually one day owning a pair of these glasses more achievable. So what does this have to do with the environment? Well, I'm glad you asked. So we know that navigating these 3D environments creates massive amounts of data. And then you add headsets into the mix, and the amount of data expands exponentially. And with terms like the cloud, it's easy to imagine data as this kind of abstract thing, but it's actually rooted to the world in a very real way because of the energy it takes to store it. And this creates a carbon footprint. So the more data we are creating, the more places we need to store it. Today, between 2.5 and 3.7% of our global greenhouse gas emissions comes from our data centers. A worryingly small amount of these data centers run on renewable energy, and this is going to have to improve and be prioritized in preparation for what's to come. Because companies like Intel are projecting that we're going to need 1,000 times more computing power if everyone adopts the metaverse. And we think our energy bills are high now. One of the hypotheses that I kept running across when I was investigating this topic is this idea that if we all start using virtual reality, that we'll actually cut down our carbon emissions because it means that we'll travel less by cars and planes. But this doesn't take into account the vast amounts of data and energy required to navigate these metaverse environments through our headsets. So to try and find out what we're looking at, again, I turned to gaming, the model of the metaverse. And here's what I learned. The average single gamer pumps 2,000 pounds of CO2 into the atmosphere annually. And this is because of the energy required to navigate these 3D environments. That is equivalent to driving 2,250 miles, which is the distance between the UK and Libya. And that's without a headset. If by 2030, 30% of gamers move to cloud gaming, which is streaming content rather than it being stored locally, the same thing we're talking about with the future of smart glasses, this would result in a 30% increase in carbon emissions. If 90% of gamers moved to the cloud, it would result in a 112% rise in emissions. Now, think about those numbers, and then imagine that they don't just apply to gamers, but now they apply to everyone who uses the internet. And I haven't even mentioned or begun to factor in the high energy consumption of the supporting technologies like AI and blockchain. While comparing what we know about gaming to the unknowns of the metaverse is not an exact science, it is good enough to confirm my suspicions that we are looking at a significant risk. And that risk is that the adoption of the metaverse is going to lead to a huge, unprecedented demand on energy. And this could result in a major increase in carbon emissions. Now, I say could for a reason. And that's because while this revelation, this admission that yes, the metaverse could be very bad for the environment might sound scary, to me, it gives me hope because we still have time to act. Ignoring the large virtual elephant in the room is not only irresponsible, it's also self-sabotaging. We must start to include these conversations in our ESG agendas and in our evolving net zero goals. The next time you're at a conference and someone stood up here telling you about how amazing the metaverse is, raise your hand and ask them the carbon footprint question. The more people who ask these questions, as annoying and inconvenient and uncomfortable as they might be, the less this vital topic can be ignored. I personally believe that we are going to figure out a way to make the metaverse sustainable, because we have to. A lot of great things are going to come from the metaverse, but we cannot be afraid to identify and talk about the risks early. If we care about this planet as much as our ESG and net zero and social media statements claim that we do, then we must take a stand and let it be known that we cannot and we will not sacrifice our physical world for a virtual world. Thank you.